All right. So here it is, a professor of atmospheric chemistry at Yale in the New York Times, Nadine Unger. The assumption is that planting trees and avoiding further deforestation provides a convenient carbon capture and storage facility on the land. That is the conventional wisdom, but the conventional wisdom is wrong. Get it? What do trees do, folks? The trees take in carbon dioxide and emit oxygen, right? It's one of the great miracles. Is it so? Are trees good? No, she says. Back in a moment. Let's continue with trees here. This is beyond belief. Of course, this is counterintuitive. This is a professor at Yale writing about how trees are bad for the environment. This is not from The Onion. This is in the New York Times. We all learn in school how trees effortlessly perform the marvel of photosynthesis. They take up carbon dioxide from the air and make oxygen. This process provides us with life, food, water, shelter, fiber, and soil. The Earth's forests generously mop up about a quarter of the world's fossil fuel carbon emissions every year. So it's understandable that we'd expect trees to save us from rising temperatures. But climate science tells a different story. Besides the amount of greenhouse gases in the air, another important switch on the planetary thermostat is how much of the sun's energy is taken up by the Earth's surface compared to how much is reflected back to space. The dark color of trees means that they absorb more of the sun's energy and raise the planet's surface temperature. Get it? That's why trees contribute to global warming, because they're dark. Dark absorbs heat. There you go. So that is the case for deforesting the world, from a climate scientist at Yale. This article, okay, I won't give any adjectives. Climate scientists have calculated the effect of increasing forest cover on surface temperature. Their conclusion is that planting trees in the tropics would lead to cooling, but in colder regions, it would cause warming. Now, I read that sentence. Stick with me, guys, seriously. I read this about 10 times, and every time I thought I understood it. So if I understand it, what could be better? Planting trees in the tropics leads to cooling, and in colder regions, it leads to warming. So aren't trees the best friends we have? They cool the hot spots, and they warm the cold spots. Okay, getting a lot of reaction here from the living martyr, who seems more like a dead martyr. Worse, trees emit... Oh, this is the one. This was new. Trees emit reactive, volatile gases that contribute to air pollution and are hazardous to human health. This was published in the New York Times. So what is it exactly that the climate left would like us to do? No trees, no fossils... No children. Back in a moment. Finally, her article. This is Dennis Prager. Thank you for being with me. Her article, that is a professor of atmospheric chemistry, Yale, in the New York Times. It is a myth that photosynthesis controls the amount of oxygen in the atmosphere. Even if all photosynthesis on the planet were shut down, the atmosphere's oxygen content would change by less than 1%. Amazing the myths that we learn. Finally, the Amazon rainforest is often perceived as the lungs of the planet. In fact, almost all the oxygen the Amazon produces during the day remains there and is reabsorbed by the forest at night. So there's no use of the Amazon rainforest. The left has been telling us that we have to protect forests. They even renamed jungle. Remember jungle? Christian, you ever hear the word jungle? Really? See, in what context exactly? Like, school is a jungle that has to be negotiated by fine minds. So we've been told this whole time, you know, jungle is a rainforest. You have to protect rainforests. And then this professor at Yale and the New York Times tell us they're useless.